Hey guys, remember when I was gonna review something scary? You know, remember when I said that in my last review, I was gonna review like a horror anime? Well, today is the day. I'm gonna be talking about Yamishibai. And Yamishibai is like a short style anime. It's only 4.5 minutes long, and that's honestly all I've been able to watch recently because I've been stuffed with so much homework. You know, it's just been so bad, and I've only been able to watch that pretty much, and I finished it, you know, I somehow managed to because of all my work, but, you know, so Yamishibai has 2 seasons, and it's 13 episodes per season, and they basically revolve around different Japanese tales, scary stories. Each episode is something different. We have, like, all different kinds of stories. They're either creepy, scary, or bizarre. There, it could be all three, actually. And they're all different, and that's what catches your attention, because they're all different scary stories. Each time is something different and exciting, and it's just so cool to see all these different stories put together. And we're gonna have stories about, you know, umbrellas or photocopying machines or falling into toilets or giant meatballs. That was a bizarre one. And so, yeah, this anime was made by Studio ICLA. I've never heard of them. It was like the first time hearing of them, and I think they did a pretty good job of this anime, actually. So I had many things that I liked about this anime. For starters, well, it really upheld its tone throughout the entire anime. Honestly, like, from the way they would color things, the way they would have that music in the background, not really music, but the sound effects, and just everything put together really held that tone of being creepy and scary or bizarre, or, you know, mainly the underlying tone was unnatural. Like, these are all things that are unnatural, and I feel like everything that was in this anime made it feel unnatural. Even the ending song, which was sang by Hatsune Miku, was perfect, and, you know, Hatsune Miku isn't real, so it's like she also contributed to the fact that this anime is unnatural. You know, I don't know, it's just my logic, and this is how I saw the anime, and I thought it really upheld its tone perfectly, so I thought that was really, really great in this anime, so that was pretty cool. This anime was definitely also definitely for horror fans. I mean, if you're a fan of horror, this anime is definitely going to be a plus for you. It was definitely a plus for me. I loved it, and I love Japanese folklore and myths, so it was definitely something that caught my attention, and that's why I was ending up watching all these episodes, because I honestly loved this kind of stuff. And also, it's like, I like how they had like perfect timing. It's like, you would think that you're safe, you're just watching the anime, you're like, oh, nothing's gonna happen, and then boom, you know, something scary would pop out, like, come on, near heart attack experience, you know. So yeah, so definitely great timing, definitely great stories that catch your attention, and just an overall pretty good short style anime. Honestly, it was really enjoyable. The major thing that will probably bug people about this anime is probably the fact of, you know, this whole art style. It's like they're paper dolls, so you could actually see like them hopping instead of walking, you know, like like that, you know, like it just looks like really stiff movement. The art isn't anything spectacular, but, you know, like everything feels stiff because everything feels like paper moving, like you can see like every single movement, and it looks very mechanical, I guess you could say. So I guess that is probably the most unappealing part of this anime. But I didn't really find anything else that I didn't like about this anime, apart from the fact that the second season wasn't as good, it wasn't as scary. But otherwise, besides that and the art style, this anime was actually really enjoyable. I actually have a funny story about this anime. It was actually Halloween, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna show my boyfriend Yamishibai, because Halloween, I wanna show him something scary. I'm gonna put it on YouTube. I'm gonna film his reaction and put it on YouTube. So I put it on, you know, the TV. I was like, you know, I put Crunchyroll, scrolling through thing, I put Yamishibai on. And of course, the episode that I happened to be watching next was the episode with the giant meatball. So instead of getting scared, he was just really weirded out, and yeah, so my plan failed. All in all, I'm gonna give Yamishibai an 8 out of 10 because I thought the second season wasn't as good as the first season. Not to say that it was bad, but it was as scary and interesting. It was just kind of more bizarre and it didn't catch my attention as much. So instead of giving this anime an 8.5, it dropped to an 8. So, you know, honestly, I recommend it to anyone who likes horror stories, who likes short stories, or if you're like me and you like horror stories and short stories, this is like a match made in heaven. So anyone who likes that kind of stuff you will definitely like Yamishibai. I know I loved Yamishibai. And, you know, it's all on Crunchyroll. All 26 episodes are there, both seasons. And they're only like 4.5 minutes each, so you have no excuse to not watch them. I mean, honestly, they are so short. You can finish it in like 2 hours, around 2 hours. So it's, you know, it's no problem. You can fit it into anything pretty much. So yeah, check it out on Crunchyroll. It's all there. And I recommend it. I think it's definitely something different. And, you know, it's short. You can watch it anytime you like, and yeah, so check it out on Crunchyroll. Thanks for watching my review. I totally, really appreciate it. Please subscribe if you like this video, and I will see you guys next time.